Dr. Scholz, one of the commenters would like to know if there's any treatments related to genetic testing besides PARP inhibitors for BRCA mutations or Keytruda for MSI.
So the whole genetic world is just starting to open up. We're right at the beginning. And the two very useful things that can be detected on genetic testing that could really help people, you just mentioned them. And sometimes it's easier to work backwards from what's available rather than work forwards from all the many, many different opportunities and possibilities. We've already done a video from Joanne Wheathouse at UCLA, who's investigating genetic testing of microRNAs. And these microRNAs are regulatory, and they're very powerful. And with the genetic testing that they're doing, they can sense or detect who is more likely to have side effects from radiation therapy and the different types of radiation therapy. They can also detect who's likely to have more side effects with some of the immune therapies like Keytruda. And so this is very useful. These medicines and radiation, of course, are very useful for people, but if they cause toxicity, it can be quite a problem. So to be able to detect in advance who's likely to have problems is a wonderful advantage of genetic testing. The initial hope of a genetic testing was that we'd be able to do a broad spectrum of genetic tests to look for specific abnormalities that would lead to effective therapies. And occasionally that pans out. You mentioned the two most common ones already, BRCA and MSI, that for which we know we have a useful treatment. The other less common mutations, we usually try and get a read through other cancers that, for instance, lung cancers may have a specific mutation for which a therapy is available. And sometimes those lung cancer mutations show up in prostate cancer. So that's the hope when we do genetic testing. And of course, it's easy to do genetic testing. We can now do it on a blood test, Guardant 360 or Foundation One, and they'll run a whole panel of genetic tests. Practically speaking, how often do those other genetic abnormalities show up and provide a really wonderful insight into a brand new therapy? And the answer is, unfortunately, not that often. So the BRCA and MSI is certainly useful, and everyone should have genetic testing that has advanced prostate cancer to see if that mutation is present. Occasionally, one of these other mutations will come through and show another opportunity for a medicine that might be useful. I wish it was more common, and it's not often proving to be useful. And we're not finding mutations frequently enough to really get excited about broad-spectrum genetic testing. But occasionally, we do get lucky.
So what percentage of patients would be testing positive for BRCA?
Yeah, so BRCA mutations occur in about 10% of men with advanced prostate cancer and about 5% of men with early stage prostate cancer. So it's not overwhelmingly common, but it's common enough that you certainly want to test everybody for it.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high-fives me, high-five, high-five, can you high-five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, PCRI.org.